The most popular Nintendo DS emulator for PC, Desmume, has been around for quite a while. The majority of people I know who played emulated DS games use it. However, that doesn't mean that there isn't a better option out there. Enter melonDS. Sharing a name with one of my favorite fruits, it offers a more accurate software renderer with fewer bugs and a simpler, cleaner UI, as well as local Wi-Fi emulation. Yep, this means you can now trade your Pokemon and you don't even need to make new friends. So let's go through the setup process. At the time of writing, the current version of melonDS is 0.8.3. However, there is going to be a big update in 0.9.0 that adds DSi emulation, as well as a JIT, or just-in-time compiler. If a JIT is done properly, it shouldn't introduce any new bugs, but it will drastically reduce the load on your CPU. I personally tested the JIT in a preview release, and I can say that it is quite accurate. If you want to try the preview release with the JIT, there is a link in the description. To download melonDS, go to this link and select Downloads. Click on the version for your operating system. I normally use Linux, but I will demonstrate with Windows since most of you are probably using it. Let me know if you want some emulation videos done with Linux. Once it downloads, use 7-zip to extract it into a folder. Currently, you need a BIOS7.bin and a BIOS9.bin file, as well as the firmware.bin file, which you can dump from your DS. Have a look at the melonDS FAQ for more information. Once you have these, place them in the same directory as the rest of your melonDS files. Make sure the names and file extensions match the ones shown here, or they will not work. Now, you're ready to start melonDS. Go to config, emu settings. Here you can choose whether you want to boot the game directly or boot into the DS's startup screen. Then click picture chat. If you're using the JIT version, its specific settings are here as well. I'd recommend enabling the JIT recompiler and setting the block size between 10 and 32. A higher number corresponds to faster speeds. However, they may also introduce bugs. If there are any bugs, try disabling branch optimization or literal optimizations to see if that fixes anything. If that does not work, try lowering the block size to 10. Now under config, input config, you can set up your keyboard or controller inputs. Next, under video settings, choose software renderer if you want the game to be as close to original as possible. If you want to increase the resolution of 3D graphics beyond the native resolution, you currently have to use OpenGL. Hopefully in the future, software renderer will also support higher resolutions. Keep all the other settings as default. If you experience screen tearing, enable VSync. Under config, make sure to have the audio sync enabled and limit frame rate disabled. Syncing the audio limits the frame rate already, and it makes sure the audio doesn't get distorted or sped up. Both of these are problems I've had with Desmume, even when I wasn't running it at fast speeds. You can change the screen settings here to your liking. Natural will switch the screen with the most action on it to be bigger than the other screen. Now it's time to run our games. Pokemon Diamond runs basically perfectly. However, since the OpenGL renderer is not as accurate as a software renderer, it causes black squares to appear. You can reduce these by increasing the resolution, although you'll need a more powerful PC to run at higher resolutions. At higher resolutions, the 3D textures look nicer, but I prefer the original look. Next, one of my favorite games, The Legend of Zelda Phantom Hourglass, runs with decent performance on my laptop. On my desktop, even without the JIT, it runs at full speed. This is probably due to its heavy use of 3D graphics. On Desmume, Link's outline is not quite correct, though it did run at full speed on my laptop. I wasn't able to increase the resolution on my laptop, but using OpenGL at 4x native resolution on my desktop looks really impressive. However, on OpenGL, there is a bug with Link's shadow flickering. Overall, I feel like melonDS is more accurate and makes it easier for users to get set up with the best possible settings. While it is currently lacking some emulation creature comforts, I think that the accuracy and features such as Wi-Fi emulation make up for it. Give it a try and post your personal reviews in the comments below. Be on the lookout for a video about using the local Wi-Fi feature as well. See ya!